Tiago. I don't know who's Marco. I just hit this lotto. I'm building up my cargo. And I know.
Hi everyone, I'm Hanalyn Pahulas and welcome back to my educational channel. For today's video, I'm going to discuss the Filipino values and moral development, which our main topic is all about strengths and weaknesses of a Filipino character. So, let's start first with the strengths. We have 8 strengths of the Filipino character. First, we have the pakikipagkapwa-tao, family orientation, joy and humor, flexibility, adaptability, and creativity, hard work and industry, faith and religiosity, then faith and religiosity during the EDSA, and lastly, the ability to survive. So, first, let's talk about the pakikipagkapwa-tao. So, kapwa-tao means a fellow human being. Filipinos are open to others and feel one with others. We regard others with dignity and respect and deal with them as fellow human beings. Filipinos have basic sense of justice and fairness, concern for others, and ability to empathize with others. Filipinos are also helpful, also have helpfulness and generosity in times of need. And that's what we call pakikiramay in Tagalog. We also have practice in bayanihan or mutual assistance, which a spirit of civic unity and cooperation among Filipinos. We are also known that Filipino are being hospitable, which we give people a warm welcome into their home. Then we also have this sensitivity to people's feelings, which this is called pakikiramdam ng ibang tao. Another known to us is that pagtitiwala or trust. Then we also have this sense of gratitude or utang na loob. Because of pakikipagkapwa-tao, Filipinos are very sensitive to the quality of interpersonal relationships and are very dependent on them. If our relationship are satisfied, we are happy and secure. Pakikipagkapwa-tao results in camaraderie and a feeling of closeness one to another. It helps promote unity and as well as a sense of social justice. So, next strength is the family orientation. Filipinos are known for a close family relationship. They possess a genuine and deep love for family, which include not only their parents, but also their siblings and other relatives. Filipinos have a strong belief in blood is thicker than water, and family is a source of personal identity, emotional, and material support. They give persons as their main commitment and responsibility. They honor and respect given to parents and elders, care given to the children, the generosity towards kin in need, and in great sacrifices one endures for the welfare of the family. Next strength is the joy and humor. So Filipinos have a cheerful and fun approach to life. Even if it's ups and downs, pleasant disposition, a sense of humor, and a propensity for happiness that contributed not only to the Filipino charm, but also to the indomitability of the Filipino spirit. Laughing at ourselves and our trouble is an important coping mechanism. Often playful, sometimes cynical, sometimes disrespectful, we laugh at those we love and at those we hate, and make jokes about our fortune, good or bad. The result of being joy and humor is that it is a certain emotional balance, optimism, a healthy disrespect for power and office, and the capacity to survive. So, next strength is the flexibility, adaptability, and creativity, or pakikibagay, madaling sumunod, at pagiging malikhain. So, Filipinos have a great capacity to adjust and adapt to different circumstances and surrounding environment, both physical and social. And planned or unanticipated events are never overly disturbing or disorienting, as the flexible Filipinos are adjust to whatever happens. Then we possess a tolerance for ambiguity that enables us to remain unfazed by uncertainty or lack of information. that Filipinos are creative, resourceful, adept at learning, and able to improvise and make us whatever is at hand in order to create and produce. The result of being flexible, adaptability, and creativity is that we have the productivity, innovation, entrepreneurship, equanimity, and survival. Next, the fifth strength is that the hard work and industry. So Filipinos have the capacity for hard work, given proper conditions, the desire to raise one standard of living, and to possess the essentials of a decent life for one's family, combined with the right opportunities and incentives, stimulate the Filipino to work very hard. This is manifested most noticeably in a willingness to take risks with jobs abroad and to work there at two or three jobs. The result of this being hard work and industry is that we have the productivity and entrepreneurship for some, and survival despite poverty for others. Then the next, the sixth strength is the faith and religiosity. So Filipinos have a deep faith in God. Innate religiosity enable us to comprehend and genuinely accept reality in the context of God's will and plan. Thus, tragedy and bad fortune are accepted, and some optimism characterize even the poorest lives. Religious expressions is very tangible, expressed every day. We relate to God like a human being, threaten, think, ask forgiveness, appease by pledges. Then the faith of the Filipino is related to bahala na, which instead of being viewed as defeatist resignation, may be considered positively as a reservoir of psychic energy and which an important psychological support on which we can lean during difficult times. Then this pampalakas ng loob allow us to act despite uncertainty. Then next strength is the faith and religiosity during the EDSA. So our faith and daring was manifest at EDSA and other times in our history, seen in the capacity to accept failure and defeat. We recognize forces external to ourselves as contributing on how events in our lives turn out. So the result of this is that the Filipinos' faith are courage, daring, optimism, inner peace, as well as the capacity to genuinely accept tragedy and death. Next, the last strength is the ability to survive. So Filipinos have an ability to survive, which is manifested in our capacity for endurance despite difficult times and in our ability to get by on so little. Filipinos make do with what is available in the environment. Then this survival instinct is related to the Filipinos who bravely carry on through the harshest economic and social circumstances. Then this result as basic optimism, flexibility, and adaptability, hard work, and a deep faith in God. So we're done in strengths of the Filipino characters. So let's move to the weaknesses of the Filipino characters. So we also have 8 weaknesses. So first, we have the extreme personalism. We also have another extreme personalism. Then extreme family-centeredness, 4th lack of discipline, 5th passivity and lack of initiative, 6th is colonial mentality, then 7th kanya-kanya syndrome, then 8th is lack of self-analysis and self-reflection. So first, let's talk about the extreme personalism. So Filipinos view the world in terms of personal relationships, no separation between an objective task and emotional involvement. We tend to give personal interpretations to actions like take things personally. Then there is in fact some basis for such interpretations, as Filipinos are quite personal in criticism and praise. Personalism is also manifested in the necessity for the establishment of personal relationships before any businesses or work relationships can be successful. Then Filipinos view the world in terms of personal relationships and the extent to which one is able personally to relate to things and people determines our recognition of their existence and the values. Another extreme personalism, because of this personalistic worldview, Filipinos have difficulty dealing with all forms of personal stimuli. We tend to be uncomfortable with bureaucracy, with rules and regulations, and with standard procedures, all of which tend to be impersonal. We tend to ignore them or we ask for exceptions. Then personal contacts are involved in any transaction and these are difficult to turn down. Preference is usually given to family and friends in hiring, then delivery of services, and even in voting. So extreme personalism thus leads to the craft and corruption evident in Philippine society. The third weakness is the extreme family-centeredness. While concern for the family is one of the Filipinos' greatest strengths, in the extreme, it became a serious flaw. Excessive concern for the family creates an in-group to which the Filipino is firstly loyal to the detriment of concern for the larger community or for the common good. Excessive concern for family manifests itself in the use of one's office and power as a means of promoting the interests of the family, factionalism, patronage, and political dynasties, and in the protection of varying family members. Family-centeredness results to a lack of concern for the common good and acts as a block to national consciousness. Now we have the fourth weakness is the lack of discipline. So the Filipinos' lack of discipline is manifested in a casual and relaxed attitude towards time and space, which manifests itself in lack of precision and compulsiveness, in poor time management and procrastination. It is an aversion for following strictly a set of procedures, and this results in lack of standardization and quality control. We are impatient and unable to delay gratification or reward, resulting in the use of shortcuts in skirting the rules or the palusot syndrome, and in foolhardiness. We are guilty of ningas kogon, the starting out projects with full vigor and interest which abruptly die down, leaving things unfinished. Our lack of discipline often results in efficient and wasteful work systems, violations of rules, leading to one more serious transgressions, and a casual work ethic leading to carelessness and lack of follow-through. So, next is the passivity and lack of initiative. So, Filipinos are generally passive and lacking in initiative. There is a strong reliance on others, such as leaders, governments, to do things for us related to our need for a strong authority. Filipinos tend to be complacent and there rarely is a sense of urgency about any problem. There is high tolerance for inefficiency, poor service, and even violations of one's basic rights. In many ways, it can be said that the Filipino is too patient for long suffering or mati is seen, too easily resigned to one's fate, which Filipinos are thus easily oppressed and exploited. So next, the sixth weakness is colonial mentality. So Filipinos have a colonial mentality which is made up two dimensions. The first is a lack of patriotism or an active awareness, appreciation, and love of the Philippines. Then the second is an actual preference for things foreign. Filipino culture is characterized by an openness to the outside, adapting and incorporating the foreign elements into our image of ourselves not built around a deep core of Filipino history and language. The result of this is cultural vagueness or weakness that makes Filipino extraordinarily susceptible to the wholesale acceptance of modern mass culture, which is often Western. Thus, there is preference for foreign fashion, entertainment, lifestyle, technology, consumer items, and others. The Filipino colonial mentality is manifested in the alienation of the elite from their roots and from the masses, as well as in the basic feeling of national inferiority that makes it difficult for Filipinos to relate as equals to Westerners. 7. Weakness is the kanya-kanya syndrome. Filipinos have a selfish, self-serving attitude that generates a feeling of envy and competitiveness toward others, then particularly one spheres who seem to have gained some status or prestige. Then the kanya-kanya syndrome is also evident in the personal ambition and the drive for power and status that is completely insensitive to the common good. Personal and in-group interests reign supreme. This characteristic is also evident in the lack of sense of service among people in the government bureaucracy. The public is made to feel that service from these offices and from these civil servants is an extra perk that is to be paid for. The kanya-kanya syndrome results in the dampening of cooperative and community spirit and in the trampling upon the right of others. So last weakness is the lack of self-analysis and self-reflection. There is a tendency in the Filipino to be superficial and even somewhat flighty. In the face of serious problems, both personal and social, there is a lack of analysis and reflection. Joking about the most serious matters prevent us from looking deeply into the problem. There is no felt need to validate our hypothesis or explanation of things. Thus, we are satisfied with superficial explanations and superficial solutions to problems. We tend to emphasize on form or maporma rather than on substance, to be satisfied with rhetoric and to substitute this for reality. Rhetoric and endless words are very much part of public discourse, and as long as the right things are said, as long as the proper documents and reports exist, as long as the proper committees, task force, or offices are firm, Filipinos are deluded into believing that what ought to be actually exists. The Filipino lack of self-analysis and our emphasis on norms is reinforced to be educational system that is often more form than substance, and a legal system that tends to substitute law for reality. So I think that's all for my report around our discussion. So I hope you learned something about the strengths and weaknesses of the Filipino character. So thank you and God bless. Bye everyone. Don't forget to like and comment my video, and don't forget also to subscribe my channel. So again, bye everyone. They say you're too tired, but I think that I love you. Mama, party girl, she just wants.